What's poppin', you guys? It's your girl Esther, baby. You already know what it do, you already know what it is. And if you don't, get with the program. Thank you guys so much for clicking on this video. If you are a returning subscriber, welcome back. And if you are not a returning subscriber, welcome to my channel. And what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button. Yes, you. I'm talking to you right there. You. I know you hear me. I know you mother hear me. You dig? Alright, but let me stop playing with y'all. Let me go ahead and get into this video. You already know what it is, you already know what it do by the title of this video, because I know you read it before you clicked on here. But yeah, I'm here to give an initial review of this bomb hair, or let me say this initially bomb hair, because you know how hair is always good straight out the package, first install, yes ma'am, and then 2 weeks later it's just doing higgy haga in the back of your neck, doing higgy haga on the top of your crown, like no. Let me just go ahead and say this right here as a disclaimer. If I initially say that a hair is good hair, or that initially it's a good hair, you have to remember that this is the initial review, so obviously it's initially my thoughts, and then later on I'll definitely give an update, or if I don't make another video, I'll just leave an update in the description box or a comment down below. And yeah, that's the end of my disclaimer. So basically, I bought a deep wave wig. It's apparently 100% human hair Swiss lace wig. The lace front wig is 24 inches. It's a size medium. And the density is 180, and I did not get an adjustable band. The initial price was $302.66, and I had a $21 discount. I probably just used the code on the site or something, and then it came up to be $281.66. Yes, I bought the hair on a Sunday at 4 a.m. because I was just like, I need some hair ASAP. So I bought the hair at 4 a.m. and they immediately sent me a confirmation email confirming my shipping address and the order detail. And then they told me to respond to their email to make sure it's the right email. I was just like, I didn't tell them that I was gonna be reviewing the hair or anything. So I don't know if they do that with all their customers, but I shopped on the Alipearl website specifically, not like the AliExpress. I've never really bought, I don't think I've bought hair from AliExpress. I usually, if I do buy from AliExpress, I like to go to like the real site because I feel like it will probably be better. I don't know, that's just my rationale. So it said on the website that it'll be 2 to 5 business days for shipping. And then they emailed me and said, thank you for your reply, dear. They always say dear. Normally, it needs 3 to 8 working days to arrive after shipping, except for weekend and holidays, which is understandable because those are not part of business days. So they're saying 3 to 8, and the website was saying 2 to 5. So I emailed them back and I said, listen, I need my hair. Y'all said it was 2 to 5 business days. I just didn't want it to be longer than 3 to 8 because I needed my hair for next Monday so that I could drop it off at the salon, because you're supposed to drop off your hair 3 to 2 days or 2 to 3 days before your appointment, or they'll charge you like $25 extra. And I didn't want to pay the extra $25 because, you know, that's extra money that I can use to go out and eat somewhere, you know? So I was just like, give me my hair. And they were like, okay, we'll do that. So I ordered the hair Sunday, and it said the UPS site said that I was supposed to be here on Thursday. Long story short, it didn't get here until Monday, and it kept on saying that it was gonna be here the next day, the next day, the next day, the next day. So basically it was just a week shipping, a week and 1 day shipping, or 6 business days if you want to say. That's not too bad. I literally loved what I was doing, ran to my apartment, went to the mailroom, got my hair, and went straight to my hairstylist to drop off the hair, because that was like my last day to drop off the hair before it was like a $25 extra charge. So thankfully it came on time. They did require a signature, but I live in an apartment, so I was kind of like scared about that, because I was just like, I don't like, they just drop it off in the mailroom. I don't like come in contact with the UPS people ever, so, and you can't get to my apartment without me letting you in. I mean, that might would have been what took so long, because maybe it was supposed to come here on Thursday, but they didn't know what to do because I live in an apartment and I can't sign for the package, and it said signature required. So long story short, I didn't sign for the package, but I'm pretty sure you're supposed to. So basically, long story short, shipping wasn't bad. It was only 6 business days. I can't come in. You won't die. Like, order your hair on time. You know, if I had ordered my hair a long time ago, would it be an issue? No. So just order the hair on time. It took me 6 days. Customer service was great because they kept on emailing me, asking me if I had received the hair, if the hair was to my liking. Oh, and if I could upload pictures to the website, they'll give me a $10 discount. I was just like, y'all's marketing is on point. Like, and y'all's customer service is great. When I took the bag out the package, I didn't have time to really co-wash the hair. I believe my stylist did so. So when I opened the bag, there was no chemical smell, because we praise God, because the last thing I want is chemicals on my head, especially during this pandemic. So I don't need any extra nonsense contracted with the nonsense in the air, you know? So let me be going. No evil chemicals will come near my body in Jesus' name. So there's no smell. It smelled fine. It smelled like normal hair. It came in a really cute pink bag that said Alipearl on it. I don't know if I have a picture of the bag. I might have taken a picture. The wig looks true to length. It is curly hair, so it's going to be a bit shorter. But I had 22 inches in before this, which is kind of stupid. I definitely should have got like a 26 or 28 now that I think about it. Because my last hair was also curly, and it was a 22 inch, and this is just a 24 inch. But it's pretty long. I like the length. A 26 or 28 would have fit me better now that I'm thinking about it. But I think it was like way more. I think it was like $60 expensive, more expensive for 2 inches. I was just like, yeah, I may not see it. So let me go ahead and stick with the 24 inch. So this is the length of the hair. It comes to my back, like mid back basically. I really like it. So when I was talking to the stylist about the hair, she definitely said that the lace frontal could be better, like it was a bit harder to work with. So I don't know if I'll use them again to get it installed, because when you're going to a hairstylist, especially like these ones in Atlanta, they're kind of bougie sometimes. So you want to provide them with good lace to work with. I mean, they're going to do whatever with whatever you give them. But like when I'm getting it installed, I want everything to be perfect, you know. Like, I'm already paying for the hair and I'm already paying for an install, so if I'm not installing it myself, I need everything to be top notch. She said she had trouble dyeing it. That's what she said. I'm just going based off of what she said. It was kind of lighter and she had to use makeup to darken it, but maybe she didn't bleach it enough, or maybe something happened in the bleaching process. Maybe it's not the hair, maybe it's the stylist, but my stylist has always given me, I've actually used a stylist for a long time, so she's always, you know, done her job correctly. So I would probably say if my stylist says something is not up to par, then it's not. But to me, it worked out in my favor. It matches my complexion with the makeup and stuff. She also said that the medium cap was too small for my head. So when I get my wig, I always get medium size or regular size. It was definitely too small because we had to like play tug of war when putting the wig down, like gluing it down. I was just like, why are we doing this? We usually don't do this. So I guess the medium might be a bit smaller than other wigs. So just keep that into consideration. Like, make sure you check the sizes. I don't know what the size is. I think it was a 21. I'll have it down in the description box below. But yeah, it was kind of playing with, like, she was like yanking my head at one point. I'm like, why is this so tight, you know? But I mean, I want my wigs to be tight, but not to the point where it doesn't fit, you know what I'm saying? I want it to be just right. So maybe next time I might have to go with the large when I'm shopping Alipearl, if I shop with them again. I love the curl pattern of this wig. It's a deep curly wig. The density is correct, because 150, the last wig that I got was 150, and I had to add a whole bundle to it because I do not like not full hair. I don't want to be seeing my hand when I put it behind my hair. Get, like, that means it's not full. Like, honestly, that means it's not full. Like, if I put my hand right here and you can see my hand, you can see my nail color, you can see what's going on with my hand, and that means it's just not thick enough. That means it's scanty, and I don't really like scanty. Even if I'm doing sleek, I like my hair to be a bit fuller, and then I'll put water in it. So with that being said, I just do not like scanty hair. Like, it doesn't look good on me, and I don't like how thin it is. like my hair to be nice and full. So also, I've only had this hair in for one day and there was some tangling in the neck area, but that's to be expected. With all wigs, your hair is going to tangle, but not on the first day. But I did wrap my hair up and stuff like that, but there is quick to tangle. I just hope that the actual hair doesn't get tangled like in the process of me wearing this. And this is also some vacation hair, so I hope that these curls last, honey. Like, don't be giving me no curls that don't last, because I'm gonna definitely call y'all like, what's up? So for this deep curly wig, I would definitely give this like a 7.5 on a scale for AliExpress hair. On a regular scale, like for my hair liking, I would definitely give this like a 6.5. It doesn't feel too dry, it feels moist. I haven't put any product in it yet, but for the neck to be tangling, and when you run your hands through your hair, you're gonna get shedding, but this is a bit of shedding, just a tiny bit. I don't know if you can see that. It's probably like 15 strands right here. But yeah, like, I also like to shop like higher end hair, so on that scale I'll give it a 6.5 just for like hair in general. But for like AliExpress affordable hair, I'll definitely give it like a 7.5 or an 8 initially. More of a 7.5. My end review will really be like, or 8 or a 9 or a 7 or a 6. But right now it's a 7.5. It makes me, it fits my liking. It's the look I was going for. No smell. Shipping was great. Customer service great. And the look looks great. So thank you guys so much for watching. I really, really appreciate you guys' support. Make sure you guys leave a like and a comment and a subscribe. Leave a subscribe, please. I am begging you. Leave a subscribe for me. It really, 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 really make me happy. So yeah, do that. Make sure you guys stay tuned for the next video and stay blessed. And my girl from the ghetto, so get you ghetto, so ghetto, oh ghetto, then forget. Yeah, when I give my attack, oh, you defend.